I thrifted this week was... What? I don't know what you want. Okay, you're yelling at me. Hey guys, what's up? It's Cort. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing one of the biggest, if not the largest, massive thrift haul I've ever done. I did damage. Yeah. I went to Alabama last weekend to visit my brother and my sister-in-law, and we dedicated an entire day to thrifting, and it was good. It was so good. So with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and speed up this intro and not blabber anymore. This is gonna be a long, long video, a great one, but a long one. So basically, get the disclaimer out of the way. This is gonna be a try-on haul, as always. I won't have the price tags, unfortunately, because I did have to travel home. I wanted to wash all of the clothing before I stuck it back in my suitcase, and that meant taking off the price tags. So I do apologize for that, but hopefully, because this is so massive and I get to show you so many cool pieces, that makes up for it. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Make sure to thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and let's jump to it. Let's go. Let's giggity go. That was lame. Do any of you guys collect these mugs? Let me know down below. I know that's not the point of this video, but if you do, comment down below because it's becoming an addiction. Okay, let's get into the haul. So to kick off this haul, I'm going to start off with three pieces that are not clothing related. I have one jewelry item and two decor items, but they are definitely worth mentioning. I'm so excited to show you. So the first piece that I had is a jewelry item. This was kind of a splurge. This was $12, which is a little bit out of my budget when it comes to like thrifting anything besides like furniture, but I could not pass it up. It's sterling silver. I'll zoom in so you guys can see it better, but it is this giant obnoxious ring. It's got like this brown rock on the top and then this silver, sterling silver trim, and it's like a double band. It's really, really neat, and I definitely think it makes a statement when I'm wearing it. I love it a lot. I call it my avocado pit ring, and I could definitely take someone out with this. So I picked this up. Like I said, I do remember this was $12. And I'm very excited that I took this. I haven't bought a ring in a really long time, so this was just destined to happen. So moving on to the first decor piece, I picked up this vintage planter. You guys know I have had an obsession with plants and vases and bottles and all these type of things lately so that I can plant things. But I really, really, really love vintage planters. I just think they're so freaking cool and they're so neat. And when I find them for a good price, I'm just sold. So I went to this massive like warehouse of antiques, but it's just a bunch of vendors and they all have their own little booths or their own little rooms. And one of the vendors had a bunch of vintage planters. Better yet, it was all half off. So this actually still has the price on it. And it was originally $10, so I got this for $5. So it is this beautiful, like, blush mauve-y pink color. It's a tulip, and it's just so cool. What I love about it is that it is flat on the back, so I'm able to push this up against a wall and put some really cool plants in here, and I just love it. So it is kind of scuffed up on the bottom, but that just adds to the vintage feel. It makes it authentic and real, and I just love this. So I could not pass this up for $5. This was definitely coming home with me. As for the second and last decor item, I picked up this vintage autumn leaves record. And I'll be honest, I purely got this for decoration. Yes, I have a record player. No, I don't really use it. And I don't really have any idea what kind of music is on this. I could totally play it, 100%. I just have no idea, but yeah, I basically got this because I thought it would be really fun to decorate, and it was only $3 because this still has the price tag on it. I just thought this was super, super fun and would be really cute in my room, and I'm super excited to decorate with this. I'm gonna need another sip of coffee before I go on to the clothes because there's a lot. Okay. All right, guys, the time has come. We are moving on into the clothing. This is gonna be a lot. Like, a lot, but truly, honestly, I love every single item that I got. Like, I love every single thing. There's nothing that I just picked it up just to pick it up. Everything is just great. So I'm gonna go ahead and start off with the one and only dress that I thrifted in this haul, and it is this really cute, high-necked, strappy dress. It's Americana, it's patriotic, it's red, white, and blue striped. This dress is honestly, like, so flattering and fits perfectly. It fits perfectly. And I love it. I love it so much, and I'm very excited to add this to my collection of dresses. Next, we're gonna go ahead and jump into the bottoms that I thrifted this week. So the first pair of pants that I thrifted are these pure white high-waisted quadruple buttoned pants. They have a really nice rib in the knee, and then they also have some fun fraying and distressing at the bottom. And I feel like it's really hard to find a nice crisp white pair of jeans in a thrift store, but we did it this trip, and that's a good thing. You can never go wrong with a good pair of white jeans. Next up, I thrifted another pair of jeans. These are from the brand Fossil, and they are like a nice muted mint color. I don't own anything like this, and I thought that they would be a fun pop of color in my wardrobe, so I decided to pick these up, and I think they're super fun. Moving on to shorts, I picked up two kind of similar looks. These are both like that army green, olive green kind of worker short. So backstory on why I was kind of thrifting these like adventurer pants is what I'm gonna call them, is I was actually at Dick's Sporting Goods and I wanted a pair of just nice hiking shorts that were just good quality and cute. And I saw a pair from Columbia, but they were like $60 and I didn't wanna spend that. So I went to the thrift store and I found two awesome options. So the first one, I can't believe I found these. Like, I'm just stunned. These are so stinking cool. So they are just like your typical high-waisted adventurer kind of like camper styled shorts. You wanna be in the video, buddy? All right. Hey, hi, how you doing? So anyways, continuing on with these shorts, I tried them on, I loved them. They are the perfect like vintage, just hiker camper wear. But then I wanted to know what brand these were because they looked pretty dang cool. So I look at the brand, and the brand is the vintage Walt Disney World tag. So then I was like, oh my God, these are from like Disney World. On the back, here, there's a patch that says Pooh Surplus Official Walt Disney World Workwear. Guys, I love these. I feel like these are not going to be everyone's cup of tea, and as soon as they saw that, they'd be like, hell no. But like, these are so stinking cute, and they're literally like the little shorts that the workers would wear on the Pooh Bear ride, or like in the Pooh Bear like attraction area, whatever that land is. I love it. I love it. So I thought these were super cool, and these had to come home with me for sure. Moving on to the other pair that I picked up that are very, very similar. They're a little bit of a different material, and they are a little bit bigger on me, but I kind of like that baggy big look. These are vintage as well. These are from the brand Bilblast Jeans. It's kind of a weird tie. They were just cute and fun. So I ended up picking up two pairs of like olive work pants, and I don't know, I think they're both a little bit different and I like them a lot. I ended up picking up one more pair of shorts, and these ones I kind of hemmed and hawed on because they're more like a poofier kind of short, and I don't typically go for that. I kind of like my stuff to be fitted or like oversized, but not poofy. Not poofy. But I saw these and I tried them on, and my mom and my sister-in-law said that they were really cute, and I thought they'd look really nice, maybe contrasted with like a black tight bodysuit or something like that. And I don't know, I don't have anything snake print, which is ironic because I actually picked up one more snake print item in this haul. Spoiler alert, I just guess I was feeling the snake print. So I decided to branch out and try these. I thought these were fun and funky, and I picked these up. Moving on to the last and final bottom that I thrifted in the haul, I just thrifted these nice workout leggings. They have the flare on the bottom, and then they have kind of like a shorter low-rise top, and these are from Adidas. My sister-in-law actually found these for me. I tried them on. I love them. I love myself some comfy clothes. Just been obsessed with that like yoga, very tight legging sort of material lately, so these were just something that I did not want to pass up. Also, the back band is kind of like this twisty kind of deal, and I think that's really cool as well. All right, moving on into tops. These are more like blousey tops, and I found some freaking cool ones. So this one is another vintage piece. This is from Silk Club Collection. This is 100% silk. I did so good, guys. I did great. Like I said, this is 100% silk. It's so soft. It's like this button up little shirt, but it's got kind of like a crisscrossy kind of like a waffle pattern to it almost, and it's this beautiful purple color. Honestly, if I was to open up my closet right now, I know 100% I do not have any purple in my closet. It is not a color that I normally reach for, if I even reach for it. Like, I don't own purple, I don't ever wear purple, and I really don't know why I tried this on. Like, I almost didn't try this on. I just thought this was such a fun and unique piece, and 100% silk, I was sold. Going along with that silk top, I actually found this one first, which kind of like set me on the silk train, and it is this beautiful, beautiful tan brown Same style as our other shirt, little collared button down with like the big pockets. It's just light. This one again is 100% silk and it is vintage. It is by Lisden and I love this. I know as soon as I finish filming this video, I'm gonna be wearing this all the frickin' time. Like, this is gonna be my go-to fall item. I love it. It's so soft. It's so just nice. And I can't get enough of it, clearly. So moving on with more blouses, this top is similar to the two that I just showed you. However, it is not silk. This is from the brand J. Crew, and it's brown and black striped. It's got the collar, it's got the buttons, and it's just a nice throw on top. It's very light and, you know, sheer, as you guys can see, but this is like perfect for Florida weather to just throw on for like a beach day or something. And I just loved the neutral vibe of it. I just thought it would be really nice and match a lot. Like I said, when I was showing you guys those snake printed shorts, I did pick up another snake printed item, and it is this little tank top. This one is a little stretched out and it is a little bit worn, but I actually tucked it into those white skinny jeans the other day and I wore it as an outfit and it was super cute. I just love a fun and fancy tank top to like dress up. Super simple, super easy, and really comfortable. So yeah, I definitely snagged her up. She was fun. Now we're gonna move on to t-shirts. I still have flannels and sweaters to show you guys after that, so stick with me. We're moving on, we're almost there. But like I said, we're moving on to t-shirts. So this one, the hell is this? Cortland picked up a bright pink shirt. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. I picked up this bright pink shirt from Costa. This was actually in the little girls section and it is a girl's shirt. However, it fits really nicely on me and I like the way that it kind of shapes to my body. And I don't know why I picked up pink. It kind of intimidates me, but it looked really, really fun when I tried it on. And I don't know, we're branching out. And we're gonna see what happens because I thought this shirt was super, super fun. I also ended up picking up one more Costa shirt, but this one is a light blue color and it's got like the pocket graphic on it. And then it has this really fun like faded ombre striping with a little palm tree in the back. Again, it says Costa. And this one is a size small, I believe. Yeah, this is a size small. So this one is actually like a little bit baggy on me and I do like this one and how it fits as well. So the last t-shirt that I thrifted this week is this one, and again, it's like that nice oversized, like I could tie it up and make it super, super cute. It's like this navy color, and it has a skull on it with these roses around it and this like framing detail. This is so super soft, but also I love the gothic, like romantic vibe that it gives off. I think it's super, super cool, and I can't wait to wear it for Halloween. Moving on, I picked up two flannels. This first one I love. I love it because it's orange and it makes me think of Halloween. This is actually like a shorter styled flannel. I don't know how to explain it, but it's just unique and I've never seen one that kind of fits this way. It's more like a little like cropped flannel, I guess. And I just was sold as soon as I saw the orange. I could not wait to like Instagram in this and like post in this and like wear it out to like spooky adventures and things. I just loved it. I've never had an orange flannel. I've never seen an orange flannel. So we picked up the orange flannel. So my second and last flannel that I picked up is a more classic style of flannel. It's like black and red and it's just really nice and thick and warm. And I just loved that it was kind of faded. It gave me that worn in cozy fall vibe. But are you ready for this? Are you ready for this? It's got like this faux spray paint lettering on the back and it says, "Expect nothing, appreciate everything." I have loved this quote for probably like 3 or 4 years now. I don't remember where I originally saw it, but I loved it. So when I saw that it had the writing on the back, I was like, this was meant to be. And it gives so much fun life to like a basic flannel that I knew that I had to have it. I knew that I wanted to wear it for fall, so I picked this up and I thought it was a really unique and exciting piece. All right, guys, we have finally got to the last section of this haul, and that is sweaters. So I have three sweaters to show you guys. Let's get into it. So the first sweater that I picked up is this more so like Cosby sweater or like Ugly Carlton sweater from like Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. I just thought that it was awesome and it was large, so it was oversized on me and it would be perfect with like some little short shorts or like over a pair of tights. I just loved it. I don't really know. It's this super fun, like tribal-y kind of, and it has like maroons and golds and like browns, blacks, and all of these fun colors. I was just sold on it, and it's super soft and not like an itchy sweater, so I picked this one up and I was excited. I also ended up picking up this poncho kind of like styled sweater, And it's very boho, beachy, again, with that nautical neutral theme that I really enjoy. But it's got a little hood on the back, and it has like little buttons that make the sleeves. And I tried this on and I thought it was really cute. I don't own any type of like poncho throwover like this, so I thought this would be a good add-on to my wardrobe. The last and final item of the haul, guys, the last one, was another sweater. And it is like this neon fluorescent green or yellow, whichever one you guys prefer, sweater. It's a little bit longer and it has these super fun little ties and like grommets on the sleeve. It's super light and I loved it. I thought this would be super fun to throw over a bikini for a beach day or something like that. Wow. Wow. I need another coffee before I do the outro. So that's it. That is everything that I thrifted this past weekend when I was in Alabama with my family, and I did really, really good. I had a ton of fun and I just love everything that I picked up. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to comment down below and let me know what your favorite piece is that I thrifted. I know there's a lot and it might be hard, but please choose, let me know. And yeah, make sure to thumbs up this video if you liked it, comment down below, start the conversation, let me know, and subscribe, and all of that stuff. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. Have a great day. Bye, guys.